My name is Nikos Petrelis, and the paper I am presenting concerns the word length employed in FFT modules of OFDM systems where undersampling mode is applied for lower power consumption by the receiver ADC. A trade-off has to be made between the complexity of the implementation and the acceptable error. At the figure at the left of the screen, you see a pipeline stage of the FFT that we have developed in VHDL in order to test the effect of various word lengths in the final error. Here you see the properties as highlighted here, the properties of the Fourier transform that allow us to substitute a number of samples at the receiver FFT by others that probably have equal value due to the sparseness of the input data. The theoretical round of error due to limited word length of the ADC, if uniform probability distribution is assumed, is within this range here. The undersampling error, as described in the previous paper, is this one. The number R of samples replaced is defined here, while the sparseness level can be between 0.5% and 10% in the cases examined, while Q is the QAM modulation level. From the constellations at the center of the screen, you can see that the position of the decoded symbol may affect the NMSE only, as is the case with the star symbol, or both the NMSE and the symbol error rate as shown with the triangle symbol. The experimental results at the right show that the errors in show the errors in the various combinations of FFT size, QAM modulation, sparseness level, and R. Not TR is the error of the undersampling error only, while TR is the error of both undersampling and truncation due to the limited word length. The conclusion is that in the specific case study examined, 8 bits are needed to achieve a low enough error, while if 6 bits are employed, the error is unacceptable. Thank you.